So the UCAD is actually investigating Tyson Fury again for actual doping charges that happened 5 years ago. And I mean, he's actually restarted an investigation. We actually don't know how this is going to end, but if actually they find Tyson Fury guilty, you know, the ban, if people are saying the ban may actually be extended to a 4-year ban. So this is a situation that looks incredible because charges of 5 years ago have resurfaced, but, you know, can have actually huge implication for Tyson Fury's future. And it is actually something that if you see Tyson Fury training camp isn't speaking about that much. So what really happened? Why what happened 5 years ago is still having an impact today? So what I mean, first of all, this is Boxing Pill, best boxing news multiple times per week. So please, if you like the video, don't forget to subscribe. I would appreciate it a lot. And now, I mean, back to what I was saying, was that I'm just gonna tell you the story in a chronological order. Okay, so actually you can make your own conclusion about it. So 2015, Tyson Fury is actually fighting Christian Hammer, okay? He wins the fight, and then everything goes smoothly, okay? There is some problem with the doping test, you know, because it tests positive for nandrolone, which is actually a steroid, but actually the UCAD doesn't make official charges yet. But then in the test, there were some problems with Tyson Fury test. In October 2015, everybody knows what happened. Tyson Fury defeated one of the longest reigning champion in the world, you know, Vladimir Klitschko, defeated by Tyson Fury, unanimous decision in Dusseldorf, 28th of November 2015. And it's okay, Tyson Fury is heavyweight champion of the world. And then, I mean, he was supposed to have a rematch with Vladimir Klitschko, but, I mean, he started to actually suffer some mental problem and, you know, committing suicide, going into depression, using cocaine. And so this actually resulted in him being away from boxing for 3 years, more or less. He just came back last year. But in June 2016, what happened is that there were actually official charges for Tyson Fury being positive, actually, from nandrolone. Okay? That's okay. So what happened was that, you know, boxer get actually really fun, you know, when they actually test positive for steroid. You know, if you look at Canelo, for instance, he blamed actually on meat or something, uncastrated meat or whatever, because also Canelo got caught positive and he didn't know, of course. You know, the biggest excuse is when actually boxer test positive. So what Tyson Fury did was that he actually blamed his positivity on uncastrated boar. I mean, you can actually write a novel for that. Uncastrated boar, blah, blah, blah. And the way he actually did that, there was actually a shepherd, you know, Martin Carefoot, that actually came and said, yeah, I'm responsible because I gave Tyson Fury the uncastrated boar. So, you know, maybe he has something to do with me. So, you know, I was the one who gave Tyson Fury the uncastrated boar. So what happened was that the UCAD, you know, went on a lengthy legal battle with Tyson Fury that, you know, was pretty expensive. And so they actually didn't manage to settle the battle. They spent $600,000 in legal fees for the battle and stuff like that. So they actually reached a compromise with Tyson Fury in December 2017. So remember, the fact actually happened in February 2015. In the meantime, Fury gets heavyweight champion of the world. Then he retired from boxing due to mental health issues. The charges were brought, and now we are actually at December 2017, where they actually struck a compromise that we say, okay, just let's not go on. We say, you are going to accept the doping charges. However, we're going to give you 2 years that are backdated. So 2 years, and we are going to start the 2 years from 2015, from when you tested positive. Now it's 2017, so it's okay. You are basically at all the effect, able to fight if you want to. And Tyson Fury said, of course, yes. I mean, I'm going to accept the doping charges. And it's like a ban that wasn't a ban. I mean, a backdated ban, you know, given exactly 2 years after the facts happened. Just come on. So why are actually these charges from 2015 resurfacing now? Because, I mean, Martin Carefoot just came up and said, I was lying. I never raised wild boar or uncastrated boar. I barely know what a boar is. And the reason why I was lying was that I was approached by Team Fury, and they told me, okay, can you please testify that you gave us uncastrated boar, and we're going to give you $25,000, okay? This happened between 2016-2017. And the guy said, yeah, of course, I mean, I have no problem. I'm a shepherd. I can testify. Just give me this $25,000. The thing is that, you know, according to Carefoot opinion, he never received this $25,000 from Team Fury even today. So he has been waiting long enough, according to his opinion. And so we decided to do it. So enough is enough. I want the $25,000. Otherwise, I'm going to go to the UK and to the UK press saying that I was lying because he wanted to pay. And that's exactly what he did. You know, I mean, I think the UK is taking actually his declaration pretty seriously, because they're going to investigate Tyson Fury now and try to see if what they say is true or not. I mean, I'm not a lawyer by far. To my experience, it's extremely difficult to prove. I mean, he must have some sort of proof. I mean, if just words, you know, we say words are taken up by the wind and only written words remain. If he has actually nothing written to prove that, then it gets really a problem. But this is not to say that, you know, maybe they found that actually, you know, the guy was lying, the Fury was guilty. Who knows? But, you know, I'm just saying that if this guy actually gets found true, if it's true that he was lying and actually Fury tested positive because he was taking some substances 5 years ago, the repercussion on Fury's hand will be very, very heavy. I hope, guys, I explained what happened. And, I mean, please don't forget to hit the like button if you like the video. Subscribe if you haven't already done it. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.